Gretel was surprised to see Muriel concerned for her, even asking Gretel if she was okay. This had to be the first time Muriel asked with that with anyone. Well, with the exception of her brother, Diablo. But what is Gretel gonna say? Gretel had started to become friends with Muriel, and she already kept the things Diablo said to herself for a while. When I started talking to Diablo, I didn't tell you about your niece, as I didn't want you to worry, Gretel explained. Why would I worry about her? Muriel asked. She's my brother's daughter, and I do need to know these family things, Gretel. I guess you're right, Muriel. I was afraid you were going to get mad and even try to attack me, and I was concerned that you'll go back to doing bad things, Gretel replied. Gretel, ever since you started coming to my hideout, you've been a good friend to me. Probably my only good friend, someone to look up to, Muriel said as she pulled Gretel into a hug. The sheriff never had felt a hug so close to Muriel as a friend before, and now she was starting to gain Muriel's trust, but it's a forbidden one. Because Muriel was evil and tried to kill her and the children 3 months ago, Gretel was willing to give Muriel a chance. I'm really glad you're my friend, Muriel, and after all this time, I never expected you to change, but you did, Gretel replied. Diablo would be so proud of you right now. Gretel had to tell Muriel that Mina was brought back to life, but didn't want to hold that part yet. Mina was brought back to life by Diablo. What? Muriel asked, confused with all of a sudden conversation Gretel brought up. Mina? Is she the one I killed 3 months ago? Yes, and Mina is also pregnant, Gretel answered. Diablo said that the baby was in development 3 months ago when you killed Mina. The baby was dead inside, but since Mina's brought back to life, the baby's brought back to life. Muriel was then hit with regret yet again. Not only she killed Mina 3 months ago, but she killed an innocent baby inside of her. Muriel felt that she was going to have a breakdown, but if she did that, Gretel would restrain her from doing so. What have I done? Muriel sighed sadly. Tears began to stream down her face. Not only she killed Mina 3 months ago, but she killed a pregnant woman. Hey, it's okay, Muriel. We all make mistakes, and you were evil back then. You're changing your ways now. We didn't know Mina was pregnant at the time, Gretel said, comforting the witch. It's okay. What happened in the past is in the past. Muriel cried silent tears out of her eyes as Gretel rubbed the witch's back. It did take a while, but Muriel eventually calmed down. If you want me to, I could bring Hansel here whenever you wish. He does know about me seeing you every day, Gretel said. Muriel then looked up at the witch hunter and nodded. Back at the house around 5 p.m., Gretel arrived home just as Hansel was getting started on cooking dinner. When Gretel walked into the kitchen, Hansel could see that his sister was home earlier than usual. You're home early, sis. How did your visit with Muriel went? Hansel asked. Pretty good. Me and her played with Brooklyn at the park. She was on a school trip, so I had to keep Muriel's real name a secret from her, Gretel replied. She could see that Hansel was making rapid stew. I told her about Mina and her pregnancy. Is she still willing to change over what happened 3 months ago? Hansel asked his sister. I hope Muriel wasn't a handful. She is still willing to change, and she wasn't a handful, Gretel answered. She did feel bad and regretted doing the bad things that she's done, and she was in tears. I comfort her, and showed her what Ben asked me, and said that she is bisexual. She likes men and women, but she thinks there's something between me and her. Well, what is it then? Hansel asked. I don't know. For some reason, she's starting to trust me, Gretel replied. She wished for you to come with me sometime to see her, and if Mina wants to come with you, she can, but understand it if she doesn't want to. Okay, I'll explain to her what you said to Muriel, Hansel nodded as Gretel placed a hand on her brother's shoulder. And one more thing, don't mention this to Ben of what we talked about, Gretel replied, with a stern look on her face. Okay, I won't tell him. Did you see the note on your desk Ben left? Hansel asked. He wanted to ask you a question, but he... Gretel then cut Hansel off before she could finish. Yes, I got it, but Hansel, to be honest, how I should tell Ben is I'm not interested in him. Well, you know, romantically. I like Ben, but it's just not in that way, Gretel said. Well, sis, you can just tell him that you're not interested in him that way, but you do like him as a friend. Take the time to think about it. Hansel suggested, as Gretel took her brother's advice. Just as a few days went by, and then it turned into a week, Gretel had been visiting Muriel at her hideout. A few times when it rained, Gretel had introduced Muriel to a few things that she did as a child. Muriel liked the activities that Gretel introduced her to, and Gretel was liking Muriel more and more. Occasionally, when Gretel was on her way to see Muriel, she would stop and see Diablo and hang with him in Brooklyn for at least a few times. When Gretel looked at the note Ben gave her a week ago, she checked it with the square with the word no on it. She placed it under her pillow on her bed. She wasn't interested in Ben romantically, and she was still confused at the fact that she and Muriel were growing closer friends. Gretel really liked the idea of becoming Muriel's friends, but as Gretel lay down on her bed before falling asleep, she was debating if she should leave Ben's note before heading out, or should she tell him in person. The next morning, Gretel woke up around 7 a.m., and Ben was still asleep. Since Mina and Hansel were still asleep as well, Gretel was the only one awake. As Gretel left Ben's note by the kitchen table, she was on her way out. Then Diablo showed up. He could see that Gretel was on her way out, and wondered if his sister was okay. "Diablo, I didn't expect you to show up this early in the morning. Is something wrong?" Gretel asked. "No, it's nothing wrong. I just thought I would come by to check on you. May I come in?" Diablo asked the question. "Of course, I'm the only one awake," Gretel said, letting Diablo in as the two headed towards the sitting room. Gretel had a rough week last week, as she had been building a friendship between her and Muriel. Ever since the evil witch was brought back to life, they started to hang together and built a friendship that would be impossible to. Gretel had to execute a woman who was caught for burglary, or at least a man at times. It was from one of the nights that Gretel had came home late, and it was the right thing. As she saw the man attempt to break into a house herself, there was a day when Gretel had a girl's morning with Mina, now helping her with anything she needed. As Ben and Hansel were hunting and catching fire, your wit caught a fire witch on that day. Gretel was busy on that day. "Well, how was my sister doing?" Diablo asked, sitting on Mina's chair. "No, she's doing fine. She's starting to warm up to the idea of changing her ways," Gretel said. "She's also starting to become my friend. I know no trust from an evil witch is forbidden, but I'm not telling anybody about it. Not until I know that Muriel has fully changed." "I understand where you're coming from, Gretel. Muriel has been through that when she was 17, Diablo replied. "When she was 17, she found a really nice boy that she liked, and the two of them got along well. Whenever she argued with her dad, she went to her boyfriend for support. And it went well for a year and a half, until a tragedy happened." "What happened to her boyfriend?" Gretel asked. "Well, when Muriel turned 18, her boyfriend was heading out to her house to see her. When her boyfriend got to the village, somehow the sheriff running the town before you did got angry." "Great," Diablo answered. "I don't even know why, but he might have found out that Muriel was a witch and most likely found out he fell in love with her. As soon as Behringer found out, he shot Muriel's boyfriend in front of the village and went, and he never showed up to see my sister. So she and I went out to find him." "Oh God, I feel so sorry for Muriel. She might have been not easy to get along with, but I feel sorry for the pain she has went through. Losing someone close to you can shatter your heart. My brother and I have been there when our parents died," Gretel said, feeling the sorrow for the evil witch in her heart. "Muriel told us about what happened to our parents, and it was during the Blood Moon event at one point as kids. She's been through a lot of pain, Gretel. She always came and told me everything, as I'm her older brother," Diablo replied. "When Muriel and I got to the village, Behringer burned Muriel's boyfriend's body, and she's been depressed, angry, and has been feeling alone since. And ever since then until now, she's never been the same. I think when I came into the picture to help her, she's feeling a bit better," Gretel said. "Then I showed her some of the things from her childhood. She had a good cry, and I allowed her to cry in my arms. She did have emotions bottled up inside her for a while. She needed to let them out." "We all need a good cry once in a while. You're helping my sister in the best way. I never expected you to do so, but that is becoming her friend, and she's grateful for having you as her friend." Diablo looked at Gretel as smiles formed on their faces. "The sheriff, Ruff we had before, never liked me or my brother, or at least my sister, because, well, my, well, it's been a, it's a long story. My, me or my brother, the sheriff never liked, mainly because we were witch hunters at the time, and the sheriff and his men beat me up 3 months ago, and they tried to violate me, and I guess you could probably get the idea. Gretel sighed, remembering Beringer being sheriff in the past, but Edward rescued me and killed them all. I saw that what they were doing, and I would have stopped them if Edward hadn't shown up, but Brooklyn was with me at the time, and I couldn't let her out of my sight, Diablo said, regretting not helping Gretel what she needed the most. Hey, don't feel bad, Diablo. We made mistakes in life, and we can change for what we did to become better, Gretel reassured him. I know, Gretel. It's just so you were on your way to see Muriel? Diablo asked. Of course I am. And where are you off to? Gretel asked with a question. On my way to see a doctor. Just for a checkup, though. Nothing serious, Diablo replied. Okay, if you need me, I'll be in the mountains. And Mina and her pregnancy are doing well, if you're wondering, Gretel said, reassuring Diablo about Mina. After Gretel left the house, Diablo headed off to his doctor's appointment as Gretel was walking towards Muriel's hideout. She could see Muriel gathering some branches and logs. Oh, hello there, Gretel. You're surprised to see me, Muriel replied. Yeah, but why are you collecting firewood? Gretel asked. I thought that job was for woodcutters. It is, but I decided to try something, well, different. Why don't you come inside my hideout? I got some redecorating done last night. Muriel invited Gretel inside to her hideout. As Gretel looked inside and saw that the hideout was decorated decently. It's nice, Muriel. It certainly doesn't look like a witch's lair anymore, Gretel chuckled, but it's a nice start. It reminds me of a cozy home. I took some of the day yesterday and the night to do it. I still got some stuff I worked on. But other than that, it'll be finished before you know it, Muriel replied. Gretel then could see that Muriel's hideout was becoming a decent home, and if there were beautiful wallpapers decorated with certain places and much more. It's a great start. I can see that you barely have much food in your kitchen area, Gretel said as she could see that Muriel will now have to start eating more human food. But with Gretel with her, she can now trust Gretel with everything she brings. Yeah, that's because I've been eating children for a long time, and now that I'm changing my ways, it's going to be hard to get human food in the forest, Muriel replied. Unless you're hunting or you find berries in bushes, possibly mushrooms if they're not poisonous. Gretel then had the idea. When she visited Muriel the next day, she then went into the market and bought some food for Muriel's home. As a good start, Muriel then turned to see birds outside. Gretel can see that the squirrels and chipmunks were also there as well. Why don't we feed the critters? I brought some sunflower seeds and nuts, Gretel suggested, as she and Muriel both went outside. Muriel was surprised to see the critters surrounding her hideout. As Gretel crouched down, she had a small handful of nuts and the squirrels and chipmunks came up to Gretel. Taking the nuts from her hands, Muriel was stunned and surprised. Gretel was good with animals and she loved them so much in her heart. Even though Gretel was a sheriff with the heart of a white witch, she really loved animals. The badgers and the raccoons also came up to Gretel. No hostile activities were happening, which was another surprise to Muriel. And Muriel looked down at Gretel. May I try feeding the critters? Muriel asked. Gretel got back up and placed some nuts into Gretel's hands. You can, Muriel, so just crouch down with your hands out in front of you, Gretel said, showing Muriel what she was meaning. As Muriel showed the animals the handful of nuts, they ran away. Confusing Muriel, she tried again, but the critters kept running away. What am I doing wrong? Muriel asked, sounding a bit frustrated. You're scaring the animals with your voice getting harsh. You need to work on having a soft voice, Gretel answered, and she led a trail of nuts to Muriel's hands. And she instructed the witch to keep her hands still. Muriel did that what Gretel instructed, and the critters began to take the nuts out from Muriel's hands. Gretel even laid down a pile of sunflower seeds for the birds, as the animals were getting close to Muriel. They didn't soon find the witch threatening to them. In fact, Muriel was smiling at the animals. Gretel was teaching Muriel on how to be soft near them, and she was proud of herself for visiting Muriel a lot. As the animals took their nuts and seeds and ran off, Muriel felt her heart being warmed up. Gretel had just started to gain more trust from her, just as Muriel was gaining more trust from Gretel. The two of them were friends now, and it had taken Muriel's mind off from being evil to change for the better. You see, Muriel, everyone who did bad things in the past can change if they want to, Gretel said. although that's only in some cases, and you've proven to be an easy to handle. At first I thought it was going to be hard, but you warming up to the idea, I'm glad Diablo was right. Mind if I take a few requests, Gretel? Muriel asked. They're nothing major, just a few minor things. Sure, what is it? Gretel replied. Mind if you bring Hansel and Mina here tomorrow? I do want to apologize to her and Hansel from the events that happened 3 months ago. But there's one problem, Muriel said. I can't remember the last time I apologized to anybody. I've never apologized to anyone in years. Well, very well, Muriel. I am surprised that you never apologized to anyone in a long time, Gretel replied, stunned by what Muriel said. Since you're changing your behavior, and you haven't apologized to anyone in a while, we're going to have to work on that, won't we? Gretel added. There are lots of ways you can show you're sorry, and I can walk you through it. What are the ways? Muriel asked. Well, one is saying sorry, the second is feeling sorry, and the last thing is showing someone that you're really sorry, Gretel answered. My parents taught me and Hansel that, and we got it through our heads after a while. Muriel had to think about what Gretel said. She might have remembered saying sorry to her brother when she was younger, but she didn't even think of saying sorry to her former enemies. But if she wanted to change her behavior, this is what she's got to do. Gretel then looked at Muriel, wondering what the other requests are. Very well, Muriel. I'll bring Hansel and Mina with me tomorrow. But you should know, Mina may not come here all the time, mainly because she's pregnant, Gretel stated. And when she's approaching her due date, she'll have to stay put in Augsburg for a while. I've seen pregnancy before, but never experienced it, Muriel replied. I really do know it happens. I'm sure you do as well. Yeah, I know how children are made, Muriel. No need to go into too much detail, Gretel laughed. I've never experienced pregnancy either. Just never had the time to think about that, after all my years of witch hunting. Another question, and this is the final one. Well, for now at least, Muriel said. Will you like to, this might be awkward for me to say this, but will you like to go out with me on Friday? Muriel asked Gretel, and this was unexpected of Muriel to ask Gretel. Muriel had asked Gretel if she wanted to go out with her. They haven't even asked each other if they wanted to be in a relationship yet, but this might be why Gretel has something between her and Muriel, but cannot say much at the moment. Sure, do you want me to meet you somewhere? Gretel asked. I could pick you up from your house. But is there a way I can get in without getting spotted? Muriel replied to the question. Gretel thinked for a moment, and then an idea popped into her mind. It was a hard question, but she got through. I guess there's a window in my bedroom. It's not facing Augsburg town, and it's facing the forest, Gretel said. So you could fly your broomstick there and pick me up there. There is a balcony, so I could come out to see you. Now, what time should I pick you up? Muriel asked. I guess 5 p.m. will do, Gretel suggested. And Muriel liked the plan. She was going to take Gretel on a date, and this might be the best opportunity for Muriel to ask Gretel something. It was something she's never thought of. But where would we go? The townspeople are scared of you from the past. I'll figure something out. Just give me some time, and I'll make sure it will work out well, Muriel said. Speaking of that, have you answered Ben's question yet? I kind of did mark on the box next to no when he asked me to be his girlfriend. Gretel replied. I'm just not ready for dating or being in a relationship with anyone yet. Well, that's understandable. I usually wait for the right person for me, Muriel said. As she and Gretel spend their day redecorating the hideout, Gretel had promised to bring food to Muriel the next day. And when Gretel got home from visiting Muriel's hideout, she then walked to the sitting room to find Ben sitting on the couch. Ben, I didn't expect you to see you in the sitting room, Gretel said, surprised to see Ben and not Hansel or Mina. I got your note, and you're saying no, Ben replied. It then hit Gretel what Ben was talking about. Ben, I only said no to being your girlfriend for a reason. Please don't be too upset, Gretel pleaded, seeing how upset Ben was. I do like you as a friend, but I don't see you as more than that. I understand, Gretel. Will you still be my friend? Ben asked. Gretel can still tell that Ben was sad, but he wanted to date Gretel. But since Gretel said no, he can't force her into something that would jeopardize their friendship between the two of them. Of course, Ben. I'll still be your friend. Hell, ever since you became a fan of me and my brother, I've liked you as a friend. But not romantically, Gretel answered. You understand where I'm getting at, right? Yeah, I do, Ben replied. As Gretel walked upstairs to her bedroom, she could see that Hansel and Mina walked out of their room. They could see that Gretel was home, and the sheriff motioned Hansel and Mina into her room. Gretel, you're home, Mina said, as she gave Gretel a hug. Are you doing okay? Yes, I am. I just got back from seeing Muriel, and the visit went well. She's requested me something, Gretel replied, returning the hug to Mina. Muriel would like you and Hansel to come with me tomorrow. She wants to apologize to the two of you. What? Mina asked, surprised that Muriel was back, but she was also surprised what Gretel had said. Was Gretel crazy? Mina had no clue on that. Only Hansel knew that what Gretel was doing, but she needed to explain the whole story, and Mina and Hansel could both explain it to Mina. Now Muriel's back, but she's the one who killed me. Mina was close to her breaking point. Calm down, Mina. I can assure you she's not as bad as she was, Gretel reassured Mina. Her brother is different from Muriel, and told me and my brother everything. Listen to my sister, Mina. She and I know what's going on, Hansel added. As Gretel and Hansel began to explain the whole story to Mina about Diablo being a warlock, they also went into details on how they found Muriel's ashes and used them for a spell, and Gretel had been visiting Muriel for a while now. As soon as Gretel and Hansel both explained the whole story to Mina, the young witch started to understand why Gretel's been out most of the day. Muriel was depressed, alone, and became evil due to her life being roughed in the past. Mina finally understood the story and felt bad for what Muriel went through. So Muriel has been depressed and evil because she was alone? Mina asked Gretel as she nodded a reply. Yes, and she wants me to bring you and Hansel tomorrow, but before we head off to the mountains tomorrow, I just gotta do some shopping at the market, Gretel said before a knock was heard at her bedroom door. Gretel, an 18-year-old girl wants to see you, Ben called out from behind the door. Gretel then put on her jacket and headed downstairs to her office. Once she got down there, she saw a girl at the age of 18 and she was in distress. Yes, ma'am, how may I help you? Gretel asked. Gretel, my father and mother have been fighting at my house, the 18-year-old girl said. They've been yelling and screaming at each other, and I think my dad was drinking too much. Boys, we gotta go, Gretel called up her men as she hired to serve the sheriff. Unlike the men that Beringer hired 3 months ago, the assholes, they were assholes, but Gretel's men were understandable and not like Beringer's men. Gretel and her men followed the 18-year-old girl to her house, then a few houses down from the jewelry store. Once they got there, Gretel headed inside their house and her men broke up the fight between the couple. Hey, let us go, the husband shouted. Look, your daughter came here for help and my men and I are doing the right thing, Gretel said. You two are fighting and we are trying to make sure things don't get violent here. My husband's been drinking again and whenever we argued about something, he starts yelling and threatening to hit me, the wife said to Gretel. Look, it looks like you're gonna have to be arrested for now, and we'll have to see why you've been drinking. I can't have you hurt your wife, Gretel said. She escorted her men with the husband to arrest him. Gretel was only doing her job. Looking after Augsburg was doing a lot better job than the last sheriff did. When Gretel headed back to her house, she walked inside and then headed upstairs to her bedroom. Hansel and Mina were still there, and Gretel stood in front of them. So you two are okay to come with me to see Muriel tomorrow? Gretel asked. Yes, sis, we'll go with you, Hansel said. Since we're walking too much for Mina is not good, she and I will take Secret and a cart there. Okay, very well then, Gretel said. That will work, and that on the way to the mountains, I'll stop at the markets.